As a business owner, I'm constantly held accountable for my actions, and I always have to, you know, prove that I'm doing things the right way. But when I was on welfare, nobody was held accountable for their actions.
Right now, the legislature is in the midst of public budget hearings, figuring out which government programs are effective and how to pay for them. These discussions stretch across all industries, and the stakeholders involved have a responsibility to identify misappropriation of funding to conserve your tax dollars.
What EBT cards are is they're the benefit card that people who are on social services receive electronically. Funds are transferred to your EBT card for your food stamps and for your monthly benefit allotment. And even with the electronic card, you know, the idea was to prevent fraud and abuse. You're still seeing a lot of access of the EBT cards, which can be done at ATMs, at places where there is absolutely no reason why people should be accessing public funds, places like adult entertainment venues.
Case in point, investigations expose fraud in the program that provides public assistance for families in need.
If you're going to withdraw cash from an ATM, you can spend it on lottery tickets, on beer and on cigarettes, on drugs and alcohol. You know, and there's no, you don't ever have to submit a receipt or, you know, provide proof of trying to do better.
I think every upstanding citizen of New York knows that, you know, we have some people that are suffering through tough economic times, children in particular, that need to be housed, clothed, and fed. Mm-hmm. Nobody has any objection to doing that. But you, when you are accessing money at 3 o'clock in the morning in a casino, you're not accessing those dollars to buy your kids clothes.
A portion of how the state pays for welfare programs is through TANF funds. If the state neglects to adopt tighter restrictions for the cash benefit, the federal government will pull more than $120 million in TANF money for New York. February 22nd is the cutoff date set by the federal government to make an effort to stop recipients from abusing electronic benefit cards. The Senate passed the Public Assistance Integrity Act for 3 years in a row.
It's a real positive step forward. The Assembly has refused to act on it now, but they're under the gun, basically, with this February 22nd deadline. It's one of the more frustrating things of all, because this is just common sense. Mm-hmm. This is not trying to take, you know, benefits away from anybody.
Look at your calendar. Time is running out. Contact your Assembly representative and tell them to act. Protect these essential programs and your tax dollars.
If the Assembly allows this deadline to pass, which would be just shameful, you know, we're going to lose some federal dollars, which, again, we're not going to cut the benefits because the Assembly will never agree to cut the benefits. What will happen is even more state tax dollars will have to go in to backfill for the loss of the federal dollars. So the Speaker and the Assembly, the upstate Assembly members should be screaming from the highest mountain about this issue. This is a very important piece of legislation. This is reform that is a win-win-win for everybody.